Now, no need to leave Slack for making notes, MOMs, or for to-do lists. This project plan template, which is directly created in Slack, having details of various milestones, having details of various to-do tasks, list of all the conversations, important links, whichever is important for the project, and all the important files, all at one place. This is visible in channel so that anyone can take a look without leaving Slack workspace. Let's see how I designed this interactive workspace in Slack. Hello everyone and welcome back. I am Gaurav Yadav, a passionate Salesforce architect and multi-cloud specialist. On my YouTube channel, I share valuable insights and tutorials on Salesforce and cloud technology. Each video is carefully crafted to provide good understanding of Salesforce and its features. If you are ready to learn about Salesforce and its offering, you are at the right place. Without a further ado, let's get started. In this episode, we will explore the amazing features of Slack's whiteboard tool called Canvas. This is a powerful feature that allows us to do much more than just a regular messaging. I will walk you through the various example and use cases of Canvas. Canvas in Slack serves as an interactive whiteboard where you can collaborate with other users on the projects, brainstorm ideas, and more. It's a versatile tool that enhances team collaborations and creativity. To get started, very first step is to you need to jump into your Slack workspace. I am already on my Slack workspace. I hope you are also in your Slack workspace. We will be using channels for our demo. If you are unsure about how to create a channel and determine which type of channel best suits for your need, I would recommend watching my previous video titled All About Slack Channels. Now let's directly jump into the demo of Canvas. To create a canvas, there are three ways or multiple ways of creating a canvas. From the Canvas tab, this is the if you go to your workspace, and on the workspace you will able to see canvases, and once you click over here, I do have already few canvases, the project template canvas that I was demoing you in the starting. I do have a canvas on the general channel and internal discussions. You may see this page as a blank, and once you go to the top right hand side corner, you will see a button new canvas. On click of it, it will open up a page, a blank workspace for you. You can add a canvas title over here. Let's say my first canvas, and that's it. It will automatically save. So that's the first way of creating a canvas. Also, you can directly create a canvas from any of the channel. Let's say on the left hand side on the navigation, I can go to my first channel and I can click over here. On top right hand side, you will see a link over here. It is a link for creating a canvas, and it will ask you what you want to do. You want to create a blank page, meeting notes, to-do list, resources. Let's say I do want to create a blank page, and I can write anything. My second canvas from channel. So this is the second way of creating a canvas, and you can just directly close it. So we discussed about two way. Now alternatively, you can also create a canvas if you go to any of the channel. This is my first channel or any of the channel. Once you click over here plus button, here you will see a option of create canvas. Okay, you will see different options: create a canvas, create a post, create a text snippet. So what I am going to do, I am going to create a canvas. So I can give a title, my third canvas from message tab. Okay, my third canvas from message tab. So this is the third way. Now how you can look back all your canvases, again we can go to this on the navigation bar. You can go to the canvases tab and you will see previously there were less. Now we do have three more canvases. My first canvas that we have created just now from here, new canvas. My first channel, this is the canvas directly created from the channel, and my third canvas, again this is the canvas created directly from the message tab. In a while I will discuss about what is the difference between creating a canvas directly into the channel or directly from the new canvas. There is a slightly difference between those. You can choose as per your requirement. Now we do have created a blank canvas. Now start filling up. Let's take a reference of the project planning template. So how I have created this three column and how I do have created this to-do list, and then how do I have added this conversation and important link. So let's go one by one. So let's say I do want to create some milestones, or let's say I do want to create multi columns. So how I can create? So you can write a heading multi columns. So this is my first column, and similarly I can write second column, and this may be your third. This may be your third column. Once you will drag and drop, you will start seeing a little bit over here. When you go to the right hand side, you can drag and drop here. It will create a columns for you. You can do like this. This is the one way. And alternatively, what you can do, you can click on this here, click for the options or drag more, add a column. So you can click add column to the left, add column to the right. So that way you can create a multiple column. We have seen how to create the columns. Now my project template was having some of the to-do list as well. So creation of the to-do list is very simple. You can just click on checklist over here, first task, and you can click on, simply click on enter, second task. And once you will done with this, you can just simply click here and it will strike out this similarly this, and you can add your third task as well. So that's how you can add the checklist. Now I do have added some of the conversations over here as well. How you can do it, let's quickly check. Let me create a heading conversations, and okay, so what I am going to do it, I'm going to convert it into the heading so that it will give me a option of kind of a toggle list. Okay, so just enter over here. So this all will come under this conversation. So what you can do, you can go to any of the channel. Let's say I'm going to this, I don't have any message over here. Let's say I go to this prod support, and I do want to add this into the, you can just copy the link and you can navigate back to canvas which you were working. And over here you can just simply paste the link. It will ask you, do you want to paste the link as a URL or a card? I would prefer a card, so that it will give a brief description what is exactly happening. So that's how you can tag any of the conversations. Let me tag some relevant conversation as well. Let's say internal discussion from this. I'll copy the link over here. I can navigate back to my canvas. I was working on this canvas. I can just simply paste the link and you can just cart. So you will see the message as well. And if you want to navigate, you can just simply click over here and it will go to that specific message. Coming back to the canvas, my first canvas, that's how you can add your important conversations. Now how to add the links. So I think you guessed it. It is exactly the same. What you need to do, just you need to copy any link from the web browser and you can just paste it, and again it will ask you whether you want to add it as a card or you want to add it as a URL. So it is having the same concept how you have added the conversation. So that's how we can add any of the link. I do have added my YouTube channel link as well. If I copy the link and if I paste over here, so it will ask me, I do want to add it as a card or, and in fact, even you can create the columns for this as well. You can just drag to the right hand side and it will divide into the two column layout automatically. And if I want to add any of the divider, you can click a plus sign and it will give a divider. It will give you a nice and clean look. It's totally depend on how you want to create it. So that's how you can add the links. Now how you can add the files, and you'll see adding of files, it will give a very nice preview of the file as well. I do have added a Word document. I do have added a image. So I gave the example of both, and it gives a nice overview of the file, what exactly inside the file. For adding the file, you can click over here. It will give you option for selecting file from your local. And second option is you can also drag and drop the files, whichever is present. Let's say I'm dragging and dropping here, and it will try to upload that file over here. It will take a while, and it will give you a nice preview what is exactly in that file. So important documents about the project. That's how you can add the file into your canvas. We have created this nice and beautiful canvas, just like I have shown in the starting. Now let's talk about different share option, how you can share this. Now this canvas is only visible to me. Let's say you want to share it with any of the team members. There are different share option over here. You can go to the top right hand side and you can copy the link and share it, or you can just simply type the name. You can type the name of any user into your Slack workspace, or even you can type the channel name as well. Let's say I want to share it with sample channel for demo, and here is project template. I can simply write a message and I can share it. And even while sharing, you can define the sharing settings as well. People in the channel can view it, or also they can edit it. It's totally depend on your preference what you want to do. Let's say I want anyone can edit it, so I can share it. And if I go to this sample channel, you'll see this canvas is being shared. Again, I'm going navigating back to this because lot to talk in this. Once you share it with any of the channel, you will see now you can start seeing over here, and you can later on also you can change the sharing, can view, and even you can remove it from the channel as well, and even you can directly share it with some of the people. And these are the general settings. What are the restrictions? This canvas can only be accessed by the people shared with, can view, and different kinds you can play around. The benefit over here is, let's say you do have created a canvas, instead of sharing it one by one, single individuals, you can directly come over here, share, and you can share it with the different people. Few things to note, the canvas created from the channel versus canvas directly created. Canvas is directly created from the channel, comes as a file. What I mean to say that if I go to the navigation again, there is an option for the files, and over here you will see my first channel, my first canvas, my third canvas, project planning template. But I am not seeing the canvases which I do have created from the channel. If I go to the canvas, the canvas name starting from the hash tag, these are created directly into the channel, but these are not coming as a file. So that's the number one difference between canvases directly created from the channel and canvases which are directly created. So now second flexibility is canvases. If you go to any of the canvas, this is a canvas that I do have directly created from the message tab. So if I click on these three dots, it is giving me an option of delete canvas, but that is not the case with the canvas created from the channel. So there is no going back. If you want to delete, the only option is you have to delete all the content of the channel's canvas. Cannot control the access. If you click over here on the three links, here you are not seeing any sharing option. You can just lock the edits, means you cannot share a canvas which is specific to only a single channel, cannot be shared with other channels. But yeah, you can copy the link and you can embed it in any other channel. Second difference is you cannot be having a full page view on the canvases which are directly into the channel, but the canvases which are directly created having a full page view kind of this. And in the share, I can see with whom these are being shared. Though you can share the canvases which are directly created from the channel by copy paste the link, but you will not be able to see how many people are having access to it, and in how many channels this canvas is being accessed. So you cannot control it, but you can control it with the directly created canvas. So there are a little bit difference between both kind of channel. Let me know which kind you are liking the most and why, and how you are using them. That's it for today. In the upcoming episodes, we will talk features on the Slack itself, like mastering the Slack search functionality, and we will talk about the hurdles in the last episode. Stay tuned for these episodes. Thank you for watching. We will see you in the next one. Thank you.